Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this video, we're gonna make this kind of effect where it's kind of 3D and gradients happening. It's very retro, it's very in. I don't really know what to call it. We'll do a couple of things. We'll look at some of the more advanced uses and we'll add a kind of a cool grain to it as well to kind of grunge it up. All right, let's go and do that now in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. I've opened up Blending 2 from the exercise files. You really don't need to open it because it's just a gray background. I have added some gradients, which you might want to do. Regardless, let's start. We need two kind of things. We need our gradient kind of line and then the shape that it's going to follow. So let's draw the gradient first. I'm going to draw an ellipse. Okay, and I'm going to fill it with one of the gradients that I've got in here. Okay, make sure it's got no stroke. It looks a bit weird with a stroke. So a fill, any kind of gradient, doesn't have to be this one. I'm going to make a duplicate of it, and then I want to blend it. And we've been using different tools in this course. Let's go for a shortcut time. Command-Option-B on my keyboard. Or if you're on a PC, it is Control-Alt-B. That'll do the blending just automatically. Okay, let's double-click the blending tool and switch out the steps. Now, don't worry too much about how many steps you do here. Go high enough. Let's go to 80. Whatever you, so, you know, that looks quite nice. You can start to see the banding. It's okay. Don't worry too much about it at this stage because when we attach to the line, we're going to have to adjust it quite a bit afterwards. So don't worry too much about it. And I want a couple of copies. So I'm going to have a little copy over there, maybe a couple of copies. All right. Now we need the shape for it to follow. I'm going to use my pencil tool. Okay, he's underneath the shaper tool. And I've double clicked my pencil tool, cranked up the smoothing and turned off keep selected. Let's click OK. It just helps with the flow of it. You could use the curvature tool, the pen tool, anything you like tool. Okay, and I'm going to draw a squiggle. Okay, I had no stroke on. Okay, so I'm going to give it a stroke so you can see my amazingness. Now we're going to get this to follow. I just have to select both of them and go to Object and go to Blend. And let's go to Replace the Spline. And... kind of cool like that, right? All we need to do is increase the steps. Okay, so double click the blend tool and we're gonna have to go quite high. You're gonna have to play around with how much you want or don't want of these little dots. Okay, if you want it to be super smooth, you have to go quite high. The only trouble with that though is that you do run into potentially stressing your poor machine out. How high can I go before my machine dies? 1,000 turns out. Let's click OK. So you probably, maybe, in my, I draw quite a long line. What you might do is draw a shorter line so those 1,000 steps work fine. All right, I've practiced loads on this one and taught it loads and it always comes out better than that. I feel like we failed there. You can also do hand-drawn type. Okay, so let's quickly do that and we'll look at some of the extra options like you saw at the beginning. So pencil tool, stroke, I'm going to pick white. And it doesn't have to be one continuous line. I wish I had my Wacom with me today. I'm stuck at home. This was snow day today. So that's why the audio sounds a little different because I'm stuck inside or stuck in my home office. Cool. That's as good as it's going to get with a mouse. All right, so there is 1, 2, 3, 4 different ones. So for this to work, we need 4 of these in total. Okay, come here, fellas. And I'm going to go, I'll keep our backup, 4 plus a backup. I'm going to pick a different gradients. Okay, now at the moment, it's really hard to adjust because they're kind of stuck in a blend. What you can do is you can double click these guys to go inside. Okay, I'm inside this blend and I'm gonna pick the first and last guy. You don't have to have the same things, okay? They can change over time. Let's see what that looks like, okay? So we'll change this first one to this kind of bluey green one. And we'll see what these, two different changes do. To come out, double click that arrow a few times. And now I don't want you guys, I want this new fella. So I'm gonna duplicate one, use our shortcuts, Command D or Control D on a PC to duplicate it. Okay, now you, it doesn't really matter where they are. Okay, and you, let's blend them. Object, blend, replace, spline. Cool, huh? Now, also, what you might do is this guy here is a bit big maybe. So you can change it now, and he can have a, you know, so it's kind of like your line weight. Oh, sorry, your stroke weight. So let's go again, replace line. Also, what we're going to have to do is with this guy selected, let's go to double click the blending tool and specified steps. You can go specified distance and go, actually, I want this to be like just one point away. Click preview, freak it out a little bit, and it will just kind of keep them one point away rather than amount of steps. But do make sure you expand this at the end, because it's an active effect and it can stress everything out. It's already, my fan's already come on. So a few things that we can do to make this, well, actually I'm gonna fast forward now to have the whole damn thing done. So let's go and fast forward it now. All right, you're back. Okay, so a couple of things I wanna show you is, to kind of tidy these things up, is with the selected, often you wanna play around with object, blend, and who's at the front and who's at the back. If you reverse the front and back, you can, like, that's kinda more what I was looking for. I'm gonna select all of these guys. Do I like that? I'm not sure. There's a lot of kind of trial and error here. So object, blend, rephrase, reverse front and back. Yeah, bits of it I like, bits of it I don't. Other things you can do is you can edit it. Okay, so I like to go to Command Y or Control Y on a PC. You can edit a couple of things, the splines and the kind of circles that we're using for blending. So I'm gonna grab my white arrow, my direct selection tool, and let's say that I want this kind of whip to be like a lot bigger. I wanna maybe pen tool, and I'm going a little bit, spending a bit too much time here. So the curvier, or not the curvier, the better, but you know, you can spend a bit more time here fixing these up. Also these guys here. Now I've got a beginning and ending shape, right? So actually let's go Command Y. So we've kind of fixed that one. You can play around with the beginning and ending shape. So I'm gonna zoom in, grab my white arrow tool, click on him. I'm gonna try and click on with my black arrow. I'm gonna double click on him till I go inside of him. And that guy can be a lot bigger. Let's have a look. Command Y. They don't have to be the same size there. Kind of felt like it's kind of, let's say it's caterpillar. Looks like a neon caterpillar. What else can we do? Sometimes what I like to do is see this bad one here. Like, it's not my favorite, but what I like to do with the gradients is, let's go inside this one. So I'm gonna double click the edge, double click it. Until I double click it and come inside the blend, I can see the fill here. What I like to do is go to my fill, gradient options, and maybe just tuck that in a little bit, right? And add another one. So I just click. So I just drag that one and then click somewhere down here, and it makes a new swatch. If I double click that swatch and go to my favorite hue, saturation, and brightness, and just drag down this a little bit. You see what's happening here? It gives it a kind of a, I find sometimes it just needs a little bit of that to kind of get the depth right. Okay, is it better? It's not much better, but it's got a bit more 3D shininess to it. You can add a little bit of highlight on one side, just a really slim bit of white. Yeah, it can look quite cool. When you're finished, double click this arrow here. My machine is struggling. My fans are going. Now, the other thing, I'll just talk about it. It doesn't have to be circles, right? You can use squares, triangles, stars. They don't have to be the same at both ends. One could be a circle, one could be a star. And you get some really cool effects. Last thing I want to do is I want to show you some kind of grain. This one here. Now, if you're finding like mine, it's stressing out and you're happy with it and you're like, man, that's the kind of thing I wanted to do. I think I like it the other way. You can select it all. Can you do it all in one big go? Object, blend, and we're gonna go to expand, okay? And is it better? What happens is it's lots of shapes, but it's gonna be less stressful on this computer than the blend mode trying to do it. The only trouble is it's not kind of editable like it was before. It's just zillions of little shapes. Cool. So adding a bit of grain hides some of the banding and just looks kind of cool. It's that film grain type of thing. And we do it this way. So we're gonna grab the rectangle tool. Okay, and we're gonna draw a rectangle over the whole thing because I want it to kind of go across the gray as well. Cool, I'm going to fill it with white. I'm gonna have no stroke. Cool. And it's an effect up here called effect, down to texture, and then go to grain. Okay, and mine's kind of set from when I was practicing before. Mine's 40 by 50. It really depends on the size of the box that you're using, what kind of grain you want, like the intensity, I'll crank it up. You can see it kind of gets a bit more grainy. Depends on the kind of look you're looking for. You can play around what kind of grain. There's all sorts of stuff you can do. Let's click OK. It doesn't quite work, right? You've got this just big white box. But remember our color blending modes, okay? And remember Pop Quiz, where is it? That's right, click on Opacity. Or if you're in an older version, go to Window Appearance. Click on Opacity, and here Normal, probably be Multiply. Everything works on Multiply, right? Play around with different ones, but it just gives, I've overcooked it. I totally have. But you get the idea there. I really want to go back and change this. The cool thing about it is an active effect, so I can click on Grain, okay, and go back in and say, actually, Dan, 40 was kind of cool. Stop messing with it. And let's have a look. I feel like that's kind of a happy medium, maybe even still a bit much, but adds a bit of texture to your really strong vector. All right, so it is class exercise time, okay? And it's gonna be a pretty easy one to understand. I want you to make your own name, okay? And or shapes, okay? I wanna just see some 3D blobby goodness, maybe some caterpillars. Yeah, and I'd like you to share it on this this website here as a project, okay? But I'd love to see it on Twitter and Instagram. So Instagram is Bring Your Own Laptop, and Twitter is Dan Loves Adobe. You probably got this burned into your heads now. All right, I will see you in the next video. Bye now. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made, okay? So you're obviously doing something, don't be shy. I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram, and on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you know you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop there's a resources tab, and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.